Anybody else want to kind of, how did you get here? Why are you sitting in this day, in this room, at this moment, saying, I'm an atheist, I'm a non-believer, I'm a humanist? Does anybody want to?
What?
Tola.
Me?
Yes,
oh,
we decided.
I always get that. How do I put this? My family is, if I'm thinking of both Christians and Muslims, but my parents, Christian. My parents went back to Nigeria. Obviously, religion began to take a bit of a hold in their lives because my grandmother, for instance, who was a devout Christian, felt all the children have to go to church. Dad was never so into Christianity until 1981, when my mother unfortunately died just after giving childbirth to my youngest sister. And I have two brothers and two sisters. That's for my mother, although I have two stepsisters. My two brothers are just like chalk and cheese. One's an atheist like me. He's basically a reasonable man for science, all that. The other one's a devout Christian. My two sisters are devout Christians, or claim to be, but they're really into their religion. For me personally, it's always been, at a point in time, I thought, could there be something behind religion or whatever? But I've never been one I would consider to be a devout Christian in that strict sense. Because I know a lot of friends or family who join really strong Christian groups and they basically tailor their lives around these sort of things. I never did. I just thought maybe it was more of a, oh, well, there could be something there, do a prayer now and then or read the Bible now and then, that sort of thing. But gradually over time, the older I got and the more I began to understand about so many other things, I got the idea that this does not add up. Because I used to have friends who were Muslims and they always used to say, oh, the Muslims are hell-bound. But when I began to understand a little bit more about their perspective, I said, hang on, they two are very certain. Could it be the other guys too could be hell-bound? And gradually these doubts began to come in. And obviously, as they say, I always tell friends something. If you're intellectually curious in life, you'll pick up a lot of things. If you're prepared to challenge yourself, if you're prepared to allow yourself to be taken to places outside your comfort zone, you'll pick up a lot. And gradually, I began to pick up things from reason, from science, from very good books, from a wide range of authors and studies. And one began to understand, this religion thing is a lot of hogwash. Made up, cooked up, I mean, certain times, it began to become more and more real to me that, yes, this is just a waste of time. Now, with regards to how my family felt, it's very interesting because my dad is funny enough, he's not happy deep down, but he doesn't say much. Maybe he's that of that school that Tola is a difficult child, or he's always been the hard one, doesn't give me enough money, doesn't do that. It's difficult. Well, the other ones are, they're more amenable. Other friends have not been happy. Other members of one of my mom's sisters has basically almost fallen on the floor when she said, you don't believe in Jesus Christ. I said, yes. She said, my sister said, what is going on with this family and stuff like that. She was really appealing to my mom wherever she was, like, what's going on here? But I don't seem to have many people who are really hell-bent in, we've got to get him back to this sort of thing. My mom's sisters in America have basically said, well, if that's where you are happy. They also believe in Christianity and they also believe in things that fly by night. So, they also believe in demons, witches. If something happens in their family, they can easily accuse any one of us that you killed this person because you happen to be in league with witches. So it's been, how should I put it, a bit of a roller coaster, but in many ways also quite helpful because none of them have really been strong impediments per se. I still get friends and family who shake their heads in bewilderment that, boy, you are going to come to some very sorry time in the afterlife, but we'll see about that. I mean, if that's going to happen, then there'll be plenty of us, so I won't be alone. But it's not me, as I said, not the much of a hard life. It's more of a just sort of hopping along the road, the odd bump here and there, maybe the odd portal. But it's been relatively smooth, in many ways.
Thank you, Tola. That's been really helpful.